Roxie? Angie? Roxie.
My God.
What are you doing here?
What's going on?
Those two are old friends from college, if that's the same Roxie.
Roxie, these are wonderful. Thanks, Angie.
What does Helen say?
We're talking about an exhibition.
That's great. When was your last show?
8 years ago, when we were together. I don't know, is it too sappy to say that you were my muse? Or perhaps my entire source of self-confidence as an artist? Your people think I killed Jeffrey.
I can't talk to you about an ongoing murder investigation.
If you can't prove it was a suicide, I'm gonna spend the rest of my life being Jeffrey Thorne's murderer.
That could jack up the price of your work, right? Sorry. Roxie.
Yeah, that's actually the first piece that caught Helen's eye. She wanted to buy it from me for herself.
Why didn't you sell this?
Something's up for sale.
I remember sitting for this.
Happiest time of my life.
Oh my God. Oh my God. I have to go.
Why?
I know how to prove that Jeffrey Thorne committed suicide. Hey, Roxie.
Now what do I do?
Well, you have money, and you have a studio. I think what you should do is your own art, full time.
That's not what I mean. Did you ever even for a second think that it was me?
No, not for a second.
Why?
Because we really knew each other once, and I don't think that we've changed much since then.
Have you changed?
I don't know, Roxie. Maybe I have, but I'm not. I haven't changed. No. Roxie and I are going to an artist retreat in Pondview.
Ready to go, Angie?
Hey, yeah, I'm all set.
I haven't been to one of these retreats since we were in school.
Well, I'll see you all on Monday.
Have a good weekend.
What do you think?
What do you think?
There was a murder on Brennan's plane to China.
Good, we're all here.
What are you, like 16?
A body was found roasted beyond recognition in a large convection microwave oven on Booth and Brennan's flight to China.
Maybe you should.
Yeah, I'm gonna.
Call me when you catch the bad guy.
Did you catch the murderer?
Yeah.
That's great. It's not great?
He was 16.
Oh.
Dying mom, cheating father. He just wanted to make it stop.
I'm sorry. That counts as a crappy day. Should probably just go home and draw a vow.
I want you to come with me and stay.
Of course I'll stay.
I mean, I want you to move in with me.
This isn't just because you've had a bad day, right?
No, because it isn't.
You've never done that before, asked someone to move in with you.
No.
You've lived with people at their place.
With my bag packed by the front door, yeah. Why aren't you saying anything?
Right.
Because you're gonna say no.
Yeah, I am. I'm saying no thanks.
Why?
It's too soon. You weren't ready. I'm not ready. Let's just see how things unfold, okay?
What?
I'm always the one to say that. Cats are so disdainful.
They're independent and self-assured, like you.
Dog? Cat? What you gonna pick?
This is a lion eating a gazelle. What's with the sudden pet desire? We're not even living together.
Yet. Look at him, Rox. Look at his warm brown eyes. His name is Donatello, and he's a rescue, and he needs a good home. One caveat, though. He's afraid of the wind. Wow, you really don't want this dog, do you? Is it because Donatello is a stupid name? Yeah. You're breaking up with me. You don't have to say anything, Rox. It's okay.
I do want to say something. And you live in the moment. I know that, but moments are fleeting. They pass.
Yeah, but we decide when the moments pass.
This one has passed. Think about the future.
Okay.
Still five by five.